everyone. We are very glad to speak at Ruby Conf again this year. My name is Yurie Yamane.
And my name is Masayoshi Takahashi.
We, team Yamanekko, have developed an mruby application and developed tools for mruby. Before our talk, we would like to show an mruby application we made. This board is one of our target boards, an evaluation board provided by ST Microsystems called STM32F4 Discovery. There are four LEDs on the board. Our demo program blinking LEDs. The blinking LEDs are controlled by an onboard timer. Okay.
Thank you.
Let's return to our presentation. The contents of the talk is here. We will talk about mruby and explain seven steps of how to use mruby. After that, we will show a demo with a Raspberry Pi and another demo with the STM board. Now, we'd like to introduce ourselves again. My name is Yurie Yamane.
My name is Masayoshi Takahashi. We called us Team Yamanekko. This is our family cat we lived with. And our daily work is ebook publisher called Tatsujin Publishing Inc. We have several original ebooks, and our each bookshop has around 200 books, including other publishers. Our talk is supported by Nihon Ruby no Kai, a non-profit organization in Japan. Takashi, I'm the founder of the organization, and Ruby no Kai hold a Ruby Kai in every year. And we are a member of Asakusa RB. We noticed that we are not professional embedded programmers. The project is just our hobby project. Some people ask us, why ebook publisher use mruby? Do you develop your ebook tablet using mruby? I hope I will do it, but it's not now. Then, what is the goal of our project with mruby? It is embedded programming for everyone without hassle. I think mruby can support our goals. We have taught at several conferences. For example, RubyConf in last year, and RubyConf Taiwan last year, and OSDC Taiwan in this year, and OEDU Ruby Kaigi 3. By the way, I guess there are some reason why embedded programming is a bit hard. For example, in embedded programming, we can use a small memory, and we can use not Unix, but Altos or NoU OS, and so on. And one of the reason is language we can use. So we used mruby. What is mruby? Mruby is yet another implementation of Ruby, ISO IEC 30170. It's not a new language nor a variant of Ruby. But from an implementation point of view, mruby is completely different from C Ruby and JRuby and Ruby News. Mruby is not an application, but a part of application. Mruby is embedded into other applications or other systems. It's important difference, I guess. So there are three points I'd like to talk about mruby's feature. Embeddable, configurable, and pluggable. The first point is embeddable. like this slide. CRuby user bin left side, user bin Ruby is an executable object, and Ruby code is on CRuby, CRuby object. But mruby is different. Mruby core is a library, libmruby.a. And Ruby code is a bytecode, and they are included by the application. This is the more specific figure, Ruby of CRuby. RubyGems and standard library is not included in CRuby. But in mruby, mrbgems and some other libraries is included in libmruby.a. What it mean? It means mruby does not be added libraries in runtime. In other words, mrbgems is more tightly coupled with mruby than CRuby. The second point of mruby is configurable. Mruby has many defined macros to configure mruby. For example, as float object using float or double, or using non-boxing or not. Mruby also can allow configuration of size of heap or a pool and key hashes and so on. You can change them only at compile time, not runtime. This is a list of macros in mrbconf.h. There are many parameters you can change in mruby. The third point of mruby is pluggable. mrbgem in C are linked statically, and many functions in CRuby are provided as gems in Ruby, in mruby, not in the core. So you can choose which is added or which is removed. It's a list of standard mrbgems. You can remove them all, or you can change other definition, other implementations. Now, let's try to use mruby. We explain seven steps to use mruby. At first point, choose your target board. Our criteria at this, time is here. Easy to buy, easy to get, be able to use float tools, and large memories. We can use mruby with small memory board, but it's a little bit hard and limited. So we want to use a large memories in mruby's board. Based on these criteria, we choose two boards. First board is STM32F4 discovery board. We have used it as the first demo. like this. If we have enough time, we show another demo on the board at last. The second board is Raspberry Pi. The main reason we chose Raspberry Pi is that it's a very famous board. When I had used SEM board at the conference, many people ask us, oh, is it Raspberry Pi? But it's not Raspberry Pi, it's SEM board. So to make answer yes, we choose it. Of course, it's also important that Raspberry Pi has huge memories than SEM board. We are not worried about memories at using Raspberry Pi. STM board and Raspberry Pi use ARM processors. Raspberry Pi use ARM 11, and it's better performance, but it's classic generation architecture, ARM architecture, a processor architecture. STM board use Cortex M4. It's relatively high performance with low power consumption. It's also good for mruby. But there's an important information for Raspberry Pi users. We don't use Raspbian or Arch Linux, nor other OSs. The reason is that we use it in the same way as STM board. And the more important reason is Raspberry Pi is too much powerful, so we don't have to use mruby. You can use C Ruby or even shell script on Raspberry Pi with Linux, Raspbian. So we have tried bare metal programming on Raspberry Pi. When you try bare metal programming on Raspberry Pi, you must find this David's GitHub repository at this URL. This is a figure of architecture of a STM board. I don't explain it in detail, but important difference between STM board and Raspberry Pi is CMSIS layer, this layer. Cortex series has a common library called CMSIS. But Raspberry Pi don't have such layers. We use CMSIS in STM board, so it can be easy to write C code. But if you want to do only simple things, CMSIS is a bit heavy and complex. So we use Raspberry Pi code to explain in this session. Next step is setting up development environment. Our development environment is like this. We use GNU toolchain, Eclipse CDT plus our original plugin, and ST-Link for STM board, and JTAG for Raspberry Pi. For STM board, we use this toolchain, GNU tools for ARM embedded processors. It's pre-built package for ARM processor. Install is very easy. But the maintainer of this toolchain doesn't recommend it for Raspberry Pi. We use home build for Raspberry Pi. Another difference is a connection between PC and target board. STM board use ST-Link via normal USB cable. But Raspberry Pi needs JTAG cable. This is a JTAG cable we use. This is how to connect Raspberry Pi and JTAG cable. We use 6 pins and GND line, so 7 pins. And we also used OpenOCD. OpenOCD is a free software to use JTAG. You can do flash programming and debugging with OpenOCD. And we need one more software, ARM JTAG, for Raspberry Pi. It's a bootloader of Raspberry Pi and to use JTAG. I'm very tired. we are back to 7 steps. The third step is a writing application. We write 3 types of code, Ruby, and mrbgems, and C code. C code is almost the same for each application. mrbgems also the same if you use same devices. So once you write an application, you should write Ruby code, only Ruby code for next application. There are 2 ways of writing and including Ruby in mruby. Just source code and bytecode. The first is source code. It's human readable. This is a hello world code in mruby. And the main part of the code is this. The second line is Ruby code is C string. The green P and red strings. It's in Ruby code as C strings. You can imagine easily how it works. The second is using bytecode. This is another hello world code in mruby. Same behavior as previous hello world code. It uses bytecode, red part, and different method, mrb, load, ilib. We use the latter style in this session, because if you use Ruby code, you need a parser and code generator. It consumes more memories, so we want to avoid it. So we use latter style. The bytecode is generated by mrbc command, beam mrbc. Mrbc command with option large b generate bytecode as C code, like this. This is API usage, but we skip this API slide because I worried to have enough time. Skip. Then mrbgems. As we said many times, mrbgem is mruby's gem. For Ruby gems for mruby. The author is Daniel called Bobby. And mrbgems needs lake file. It's like a gem spec file of Ruby gems. In addition, mruby has a mini lake file. Mini lake is a subset of lake, so you do not have to install lake even if using 1.8, Ruby 1.8. In previous read, all the mruby has used CMake, but build system had become much complex, so some people want to use Ruby to build mruby. But Matt decided that mruby can be built in Ruby 1.8 without Ruby gems. I'm right? Matt said right. So Matsui-san made mini lake and we have used it. You can use not mini lake, but lake itself you can build with mruby. The main configuration file described how to build mruby is buildconfig.rb. Buildconfig is Ruby script that is executable in execute in host machine, not target machine. It's like DSL to build mruby. Its default minimal build config.lrb using GCC as tool chain and Genbox using default Genbox. Genbox is a bundle of gems, mrb gems.
It makes the same demo at the STM suite, but with the Raspberry Pi. We will make the LED blink connected to the GPIO. We will write the code. The flash is the LED on and off in Ruby. The example code flashes green, orange, red, blue, on and off in turn. First, we write the Ruby part. We have two parts in Ruby. One part is initialization of LED. Another part is blinking the LED. First, we show the initialization part. We have LED class. LED.new has one argument. This argument is the pin number. The pin number depends on the board we use. So we have constants for LED by color, red, orange, blue, and green. The value of these constants is the pin number as an integer. We assign object of LED to instance variable, and we use one variable as a flag. We use this variable to manage the state of the building blinking LED. At last, we also initialize timer. So we have finished. Let's see another part. This code will be executed periodically. TIMTIRQ handler function is called from a hardware interrupt. This function is called periodically. The period is the interval I set an initialization. Let's take a look inside. At first, I call a check method and I clear the interrupt notification. Next, it is very simple case statement. When the LED is on, the toggle method turns the LED off. And when LED is off, the method turns it on. Toggle method is called for four LED in turn. You can download the Eclipse plugin for mruby from the Yamanekko site. In the Eclipse menu, select Help and Install New Software. Connect to Yamanekko site. Choose mruby tools plugin, then install it. Make a project for mruby. To create the project, just clone from GitHub. Create a mruby gem that controls the LED. If you use mruby tool plugin, you can create an mruby gem template. It creates the minimum directories and files you need. It makes init and final functions. We will add the processing code to the created project. Let's customize the build config for Raspberry Pi. We will just add what we need to use mruby gems. When you build the mruby project, it creates libmruby.a. You use this to create an application. Let's create a Raspberry Pi project. First, create Eclipse C project and necessary files .c file, startup routine, memmap, etc. This plugin can convert Ruby code to bytecode, which can be included in the C language file. The code between the start tag and end tag is passed to mrbc. It creates file that includes the bytecode, return from mrbc, and code to execute the compiled bytecode. You can insert the start tag and end tag by clicking the C or F button. C means code, F means file. The C button is for writing Ruby code. The F button is for writing a Ruby file name. This Ruby code uses the converter. You can change to bytecode. Use OpenOCD for debug on hardware. This is the setting to use OpenOCD from Eclipse. This is log, Select OpenOCD from external tool menu. This is log, I start OpenOCD. Connect by telnet and select hot. Set into remote target, localhost 3333, start debugging. Now we can set breakpoints in Ruby's bytecode, so I set breakpoints in mruby code. Okay, let's try it.
This is a telnet session to connect OpenOCD as a command interface.
Set a breakpoint at mrb-ls-led-toggle method. This method is called from Ruby's toggle method. I start debugging. Stop at the breakpoint. The status is now status. Call MRB LED on. N is pin number. The LED on.
Like this.
To connect, repeat this 4 times. Yes. Next one, off. It is break point. I remove all break points. GC isn't a work this board. Next, another demo. It starts when I switch it on, and LED flash on and off. When I push the blue button, it becomes a tilt sensor. If I detect a tilt with an acceleration sensor at a tilt above a certain level is measured, the LED for the direction turn on. When I push the blue button again, it switches to LED blinking. Let me summarize. It changes states when you press the blue button. There are two states. As for the first, LED flash on and off with a regular interval. As for the second, an acceleration sensor measures tilt and displays the degrees of the tilt. Let's start. Connect the SD link. It failed. Let's try it again. Oh, okay, okay. To start the bug. Sorry, try it again. Blinking LED, the push button, and the tilt sensor. The push. The. Oh. Try again. The tilt sensor and press the back. Ah, 帰らない. The feature issues, the source code level debugger, support bytecode generated by mrbc, and more mrbgems samples.
Thank you very much.